I just want to bring in Dr. Pete Watson immediately, who is Chief Medical Officer at the County's Manukau DHB. We're talking, of course, about this patient at Middlemore Hospital who tested positive for COVID-19 after arriving at the hospital's emergency department. Dr. Watson, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate your time. Gosh, there's a lot to discuss. Of course, Middlemore's ground zero, right? So your emergency staff personnel are just PPE'd up. Tell me what happened.
Yeah, so you're right, John. We are at the middle of what, and the centre of what's a lot of the clusters and a lot of the cases in South Auckland now. So we do expect to see people. So our staff are all PPE'd up and taking protective steps to ensure keeping safe. But in this instance, a person comes in with a completely unrelated presentation to COVID, hasn't been to any locations of interest, hasn't had any contacts, has no symptoms, is seen and assessed in our emergency department. As part of that, actually, because we are so keen to ensure that we don't miss anybody, somebody does take us a COVID swab. The person leaves the emergency department within less than 2 hours of being there because they don't need to be there. And then after they've left, we get back a positive result. Of course, we do all the checking really quickly to make sure it is a positive result. It is. And subsequent to that, we've found the person, we've supported them to be in contact with Auckland Regional Public Health and they're managing her to be placed in managed isolation. But now we've got a whole lot of exposed patients and visitors in the department. So that's quite a big job. We've identified all those people, informed them, we put them into isolation where necessary, and following up today.
Boy, you can't get a lucky break, you buggers, can you? I just want to, we have to be careful how we report these stories, because there was a sense from some of the reporting I've seen that this person somehow withheld something from you, and that in good faith they might have been reasonably expected to know they had COVID, but you're telling me that she was completely asymptomatic and there was no reason for her whatsoever to suspect she had COVID.
That's correct, John. And so I think people really need to get clear about that. So when they come to hospital, and we really want people to come to hospital if they need healthcare, so please don't stay away. We're open, we're seeing more than 200 people a day. When you come, you will be screened. Please tell the truth so we can care for you and protect everyone. You'll still be seen, we'll provide the care you need, but not everybody does. And some people have asymptomatic presentations.
Did this person tell the truth though? So there was just no reason. Do you think that she might have had cause to know?
We have no reason to not believe her,
okay.
We do know there are asymptomatic cases. And I guess that's one of the other reasons we're really keen for everybody, particularly in the South Auckland County's Manukau area, to go and get swabbed if they do have any symptoms or if they've been to any location of interest. We really need to drive up those testing rates at the moment to ensure that we identify all the possible cases that are out there in the community.
Yes, testing is everything at the moment, isn't it? And I guess that's the argument for level four, isn't it? That we have to be in our bubble so as not to spread Delta. Are you concerned about your staff?
We're always concerned about ensuring our staff are kept safe, hence why we're so vigilant around PPE, masks wearing, N95 use. We work in pods so we can protect people if there is a case where there's people have been exposed. So we're really going to as much care as we can to be ensure that the safety of our staff.
Was this person vaccinated? Had they had one or two vaccines?
As far as I know, they weren't. Of course, that's been followed up by Regional Public Health, but as far as I'm aware, they weren't. So that's the other key message here. We know of all of the people who are becoming unwell with COVID, and particularly those people who become really unwell, so they need to be in hospital or ICU. 90% or roughly 90% of those people have not been fully vaccinated or have not been a couple of weeks after being fully vaccinated, which is when you get the full protection. So we have to get vaccinated. And, you know, the numbers are getting up, but we have to drive that home and get it up as high as possible.
We've got to go to the 7 o'clock news, and I'm so sorry. But Dr. Watson, to end, you are saying if you are remotely symptomatic, get tested. You must behave as if you were living in a bubble, get your vaccines and tell the full story about where you have been and who you have been with.
That's great messaging, John. And please make sure you come to the hospital if you need healthcare. We want to make sure that nobody is not receiving healthcare because they stay away because they're fearful of the hospital. We have got all of the processes to give you and protect you, and our staff are there ready to help.
Dr. Pete Watson from the County's Manukau DHB, thank you so much for your time this morning. We really appreciate it.
Good afternoon.